Hello students, in today's lecture we will be revising and practicing some MCQs for chapters 2 and 3. Let us start with a few questions from chapter 2, Cell, the Unit of Life. First question. Which of the following is incorrectly matched with its function? Centrosomes carries genes. Centrioles forms spindle fibers. Chromatin fibers present in the nucleus. Plasmids extra chromosomal DNA in prokaryotes. You can always pause the video to answer the question and check back to see the right answer. So in the given options, centrosome is the incorrect because centrosomes are composed of a pair of centrioles. Okay, and centrioles, what they are doing? They are forming spindle fibers. So these are involved in the cell division. Okay. In cell division, they are very important. Okay, centrioles, it forms spindle fibers, that is correct. Chromatin fibers, they are present in the nucleus. Okay, plasmids are nothing but the extra chromosomal DNA, that is the DNA which is not part of the chromosome. And where is it present? It is present in the prokaryotes, that is the bacteria. Okay, so let us move to the next question. Which of the following is incorrectly matched? Cytoplasm. Aerobic respiration takes place here. Protoplasm. Cytoplasm plus nucleus or nucleoplasm. Ribosomes. Protein factories of the cells. A rough endoplasmic reticulum is associated with ribosomes. So, which of these is the incorrect? The answer is cytoplasm, because in the cytoplasm, what takes place? Anaerobic respiration. Okay, anaerobic respiration. So anaerobic respiration is, it takes place in the absence of oxygen. Okay, it takes place in the absence of oxygen. So protoplasm is nothing but a combination of the cytoplasm and nucleoplasm. Ribosomes. Ribosomes are known as the protein factories of the cells because they manufacture these proteins. They synthesize the proteins. It is the site of the preparation of the proteins, ribosomes. Rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay. Rough endoplasmic reticulum, it is associated with the ribosomes. That is why it appears rough. Okay. Next question. Which of the following is incorrectly matched? Nucleus present only in eukaryotes. Nucleoid present in prokaryotes. Chromosomes, extended form of chromatin fibers. All of the above. So, which of them is incorrect? Chromosomes are not the extended form, they are the condensed form or compact. Okay, or the compact form of the chromatin fibers. So the chromatin fibers that are present in the nucleus, when they get very compactly packed, very highly condensed, so then they appear as the chromosomes. Okay, they appear as the chromosomes. Nucleus, it is only present in the eukaryotes, it is not present in the prokaryotes. Okay, prokaryotes means what? Pro means primitive nucleus. So what is there in the prokaryotes? Nucleoid is there. So instead of nucleus, we say nucleoid. Okay, in the case of prokaryotes. Next question. Which of the following is incorrectly matched? Plasma membrane, semi-permeable. Mitochondria, powerhouse of the cell, produces ATP, aerobic respiration. Cristae, inner membrane of the Golgi apparatus. All of the above. So which is incorrect? Cristae. Cristae is the inner membrane of the mitochondria. Okay, the inner membrane of the mitochondria is known as the cristae. The mitochondria is known as the powerhouse of the cell. It produces the ATP, which is the energy currency molecule. And what kind of respiration takes place in mitochondria? It is the aerobic respiration. The plasma membrane, it is semi-permeable. It is partially, selectively permeable. It doesn't allow all the types of molecules to pass through it. Next question. Which of the following is incorrectly matched? Chloroplast, present only in plants, traps solar energy. Leucoplast, present in brightly colored petals. Chromoplast, contains color pigments like xanthophyll, which is yellow in color, and carotene, which produces a red-orange color. Anthocyanins, the pigments of flower dissolved in the cell sap. So which of these is incorrect? Leucoplast, what does it store? It stores starch. Okay, leucoplast stores starch. Therefore, it is present in the, for example, the tuber of the potatoes and so on, but not in the flowers. It is not present in the brightly colored petals of the flowers. So what is present in the petals of the flowers? It may be anthocyanins, okay, which are the pigments of the flower that are dissolved in the cell sap, okay, or they may be the chromoplast, okay, chromoplast, which are the color pigments like the xanthophyll and carotene. And the chloroplast, most of you know, is present in the leaves, and it is involved in the trapping of solar energy for photosynthesis. Next question. Which of the following is incorrect? Plant cell wall, made up of cellulose, freely permeable. Vacuoles, large size in plant cells. Lysosomes, intracellular digestion, present in only animal cells. More than 40 digestive enzymes are present. Nucleolus produces DNA. Which of these following is incorrect? The answer is nucleolus. The nucleolus produces ribosomes. Okay, it produces ribosomes. So nucleolus is the region that is present inside the nucleus. It appears very dense. Okay, and what does it produce? It produces the ribosomes. And you already know that the ribosomes, what do they produce? They produce the proteins. Okay, the lysosomes are the intracellular, they are involved in the intracellular digestion. They are present only in animal cells, not in plant cells. And they are having more than 40 digestive enzymes. The vacuoles, they are present in plant cells in very large size. In animals, they may be very few, very small, or may be absent. The plant cell wall, it is made up of cellulose and it is freely permeable. Okay, whereas the plasma membrane is semi-permeable. Next question. Which of the following is incorrectly matched? Golgi apparatus in animals and dictyosomes in plants. They are involved in the synthesis and secretion of enzymes and hormones. Cisternae. They are a group of hollow membranous tubular structures in the Golgi. Endoplasmic reticulum. They are involved in the synthesis and transport of proteins and fats. All of the above. So, which of the following is incorrect? Is option A incorrect? Where the Golgi and dictyosomes are involved in the synthesis and secretion of enzymes and hormones? It is correct. It is a correct, it is a true. Okay. It is involved in the secretory function, Golgi and dictyosomes. Cisternae, they are hollow membranous tubules of the Golgi. That's also true. Endoplasmic reticulum, they are involved in the synthesis and transport of proteins and fats. That is also true. Okay. So, in this particular question, all the options are true. None of them are incorrect. Okay. So, all are correct. All are true. Okay. Next question. Which of the following is incorrect? Glycogen granules absent in animals, present in plants. Starch granules absent in plants, present in animal cells. Cell sap in animal cells, liquid contained in large vacuoles. All of the above. The answer is all of the above. All of them are incorrect because glycogen is present in the animal cells. Okay, it is present in the animal cells and it is absent in the plant cells. Okay, whereas the starch granules, they are present in the plant cells and absent in the animal cells. Cell sap is present in the plant cells, okay, not animal cells. And cell sap is nothing but the liquid that is contained within the large vacuoles. Okay, next question. Other than the nucleus, DNA may be present in the cell. Where it may be present? Mitochondria, chloroplast, plasmids as in prokaryotes, or all of the above? The answer is all of the above. DNA may also be present in the mitochondria, chloroplast and plasmids. Okay. It is, the DNA is present in the nucleus, but it can also be present in the mitochondria, chloroplast and plasmids. Genes are made up of DNA, deoxyribonucleic acids, RNA, ribonucleic acids, protein or fats. The answer is DNA. Okay. Genes are made up of what kind of chemical compound? They are made up of DNA, that is the deoxyribonucleic acid. Next question. The number of chromosomes in the skin cells of humans is 23, 46, 14, 24. The right answer is 46. Okay, here it is mentioned as the skin cells. They are the normal cells. So, when we take any type of cell other than the reproductive cells, other than the gametes, they will have how many? They will have 46 chromosomes, which is nothing but 23 pairs. Okay. But in the case of gametes, how many chromosomes will be there? 23 chromosomes will be there. That is the half. Okay. Next question. Cell theory was proposed by Schleiden and Schwann. Which of the following statements is true? Cells are the smallest unit of the structure of all living things. Cell is the unit of function of all living things. All cells arise from pre-existing cells. All of the above. The right answer is all of the above. Which of the following cuboidal cells would have the highest efficiency, with each of its sides measuring, considering a cuboidal cell, okay. This is a cuboidal cell. Each side of this is this dimension, either 2 mm, 20 mm, 200 mm, or 2000 mm. So with these kind of dimensions, which of these kind of cell will have the highest efficiency? The answer is 2 mm. Okay, so the surface area to volume ratio is important. The one which is the smallest in size, okay, and one that is larger in size, the smaller one will have the more efficiency because it will have the more surface area. Okay, next question. A combination of ordinary light and glass lenses is used in the simple and compound microscopes to magnify an image. What is used in the electron microscope? Is it ordinary light and high power glass lens? Is it laser light and high power glass lenses? Is it gamma radiation and magnets? Or is it electron beam and magnets? The answer is electron beam and magnets. Okay, so electron beam is used. Okay, and this electron beam, its focal length and its adjustments are done with the help of powerful magnets. Next, the nature of magnifying glass lens and light collecting mirror used in the compound microscopes are concave lens, convex mirror, biconvex lens, convex mirror, biconvex lens, concave mirror, biconcave lens, concave mirror. The answer is biconvex lens and concave mirror. Okay, so this kind of lens, okay, this is the biconvex lens. Okay, this kind of lens is used in the case of a simple and compound microscope. But when we want to focus more amount of light on the sample, then we use the mirror. Okay, this is the mirror. So when light is falling on this one, because it is a concave, it will get concentrated. It will get concentrated in the center. In this way, you are able to collect the light. So it is a concave mirror. Okay, so concave mirror is useful in collecting the light and focusing the light on the sample. Okay, moving to the next question from chapter 3, tissues. Let us see the first question. Which of the following is included in the chief characteristics of meristematic tissue? Actively dividing cells. Cells are small, cubical, cell wall thin, nuclei large, vacuoles absent. Intercellular spaces minimum. Differentiate into permanent tissue. All of the above. The answer is all of the above. All the above are the characteristics of a meristematic tissue. A meristematic tissue is very actively dividing cells. Okay, they have a prominent nucleus, vacuoles are absent, with minimum intercellular space, and they differentiate into the permanent tissue. Next question. Which of the following is true? Permanent tissue are non-dividing cells that are living, that is the nucleus present, or dead, nucleus absent. Protective tissue, which is the epithelial, have thick cell wall and are found on the surface of stem, leaves and roots. Supportive tissue, there are three types including parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. All of the above. The right answer is all of the above. Okay. So the permanent tissue are non-dividing, they may be living or non-living, whereas the protective tissue, which is the epithelial tissue, generally have a thick cell wall and they are present on the surface of the stem, leaves and roots. Protective, the supportive tissue are three types: parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Which of the following statements is not true? Parenchyma cells are thin-walled, single large vacuole present, found in soft parts of the plants like the pith and cortex, provides temporary support to the plant, may store food as in the case of potato. Chlorenchyma, elongated cells with cell wall thickened at the corners, found in the leaf stalk below epidermis of the stem, provides support to the plant parts. Sclerenchyma, dead, long and narrow cells, cell wall thick due to lignin deposition, found in stems and veins of the leaves, provides strength to plant parts. All of the above. The answer is chlorenchyma. Here, most of the students, they may confuse with colenchyma and chlorenchyma. Okay, so here it should be colenchyma, C-O-L-L-E-N-C-H-Y-M-A, okay, colenchyma, okay, chlorenchyma means it is the chlorophyll containing parenchyma cells, okay, that are present in the leaves, okay, so chlorenchyma is different from colenchyma. Next, the complex tissue includes the conducting or vascular tissues, that is the xylem and phloem. Which of the following statements is not true? Xylem, they are elongated, thick-walled, upward movement of water and minerals. Older xylem is woody and does not involve in the transport. Annual rings help in the determination of the age of the tree. Xylem vessels or trachea, these are dead cells, long tube-like structures without transverse walls, forms a continuous water pipe, hard, thick and lignified. Xylem tracheids, living cells, elongated cells with empty cavity, highly lignified cell wall, mechanical support. Xylem fibers, dead sclerenchyma cells, thick walled, long, narrow, tapered ends, provides mechanical support. The right answer is xylem tracheids. Xylem tracheids are not living, these are the dead cells. Okay. Xylem vessels or trachea are also dead cells. Okay. So xylem tracheids are dead, xylem fibers are dead. Only xylem parenchyma, okay, xylem parenchyma are living cells. Okay, they are involved both in the storage as well as the conduction of water and minerals. Okay, next, the phloem is involved in bidirectional transport of food. Which of the following statements is not true? Sieve cells, these are elongated cells placed end to end, transverse walls are absent. Companion cells, living parenchyma cells closely associated with sieve cells. Phloem parenchyma, living parenchyma cells, storage of starch, fat and other organic food material. Phloem fibers, these are sclerenchymatous cells, provide support. The right answer is sieve cells. Here, the transverse walls are present. So, if we look at the cross section of a sieve cell, it will have the cross wall. Okay, it will have the cross wall, but the cross wall will have a lot of sieves or holes or pores. Okay, it will have like this. So But in the case of the xylem trachea or vessels, there is no cross wall. In the case of the phloem, the sieve cells, they have the sieve or this pores like structure in the cross wall. Next question. Which tissue type is correctly matched with its location? Squamous epithelium, lining of the mouth, nasal cavities, blood vessels and lymph vessels. Cuboidal epithelium, parts of the kidney tubules, salivary and pancreatic glands. Ciliated columnar epithelium, trachea. Glandular epithelium, lining the stomach and intestine. Stratified epithelium, skin and cornea. So here, all of them are correctly matched with their corresponding lines. Okay. So kindly revise, use this and revise the location of these types of tissues and the organ. Next question. Which tissue type is correctly matched with its location? Areolar or packing tissue, beneath the epidermis of the skin. Adipose or fat tissue, the padding under the skin around the kidneys, eyeballs, etc. Cartilage, tip of nose, external ears, trachea, bronchial tubes, between vertebrae, ends of long bones. Striated muscles, voluntary, present in the arms, legs, face, neck, etc. Unstriated muscles, walls of intestine, muscles of the iris, skin, lining of the blood vessels, urinary bladder, uterus, etc. The correct answer is all of the lines are matched with their corresponding lane. Which of the following statements is not true? Cartilage is non-porous, blood vessels and nerves are absent, semi-transparent and elastic. Bone is hard and porous tissue, it has blood vessels and nerves. Osteoblasts are dead and hard cells of the bone, all of the above. The right answer is osteoblasts are living. They are living cells of the bones. Which of the following statements is not true? Plasma is the liquid part of the blood without the cells. Perikaryon or cyton is the cell body of the nerve cell without a nucleus. Dendron or dendrites are extensions, okay, of the nerve cells, all of the above. The answer is perikaryon or cyton is cell body of the nerve cell with a nucleus. Okay, it consists of a nucleus. So these are a few questions that we have discussed. So kindly revise your chapters, solve some questions from your textbook, as well as you can use these also. Okay, prepare well. All the best. Thank you.